All right, so hi everyone. Good evening, my name is Ishita and I am from Belcure. I will be hosting the session for today. First of all, I would like to welcome you all to the session. Some of you must have already attended a couple of workshops with us. And if you are new to our platform, I would like to quickly tell you about Belcure. So Belcure is a digital natural healing platform where we regularly conduct workshops, events related to natural living, natural eating. We have quite a lot of, if you are passionate about, this kind of living, then you should definitely check out all the other interesting workshops and programs happening on our platform as well. You can get the updates from our website, that's www.belcure.com, or you can download the app and you will be notified about that there as well. So, today is the introductory session for a very interesting workshop, the DIY do-it-yourself soaps workshop. And just a few points of instructions before we begin. We have disabled the microphones so that we have a disturbance-free session. We will be opening the chat when we are open for Q&A. So keep noting your questions throughout the session. And preferably the questions which are relevant to the topic that we are talking about today. You can also take down notes, and we'll be taking up questions right at the end of the session. So we will be opening the chat box and you can put in your questions there. We would be very happy to answer as many as we can. Okay. So next slide, please, Karishma. Is there a problem?
Yeah, I'm not able to switch to the next slide.
Okay, you can stop sharing the screen. I'll do it. Okay, so sorry for that glitch. So for today's introductory session, it's a complimentary one. So what we are looking at covering is basically, there'll be a brief presentation from our expert, that's Sunmeet Marwaha, followed by a really interesting recipe demo of Rasool clay spa soap. We'll also be telling you about the actual workshop and what all will be covered, which all recipes will be covered, what theory aspects will be covered. All of that you will be told in the session. And then we will be opening our forum for questions. If you have anything related to the workshop or what was covered today, you can go ahead and ask all those questions. And to introduce you all to our program expert for today. So Sunmeet has already been with us for some really interesting and much loved and very popular workshops, the skincare, the hair care workshop. And this is yet another wonderful workshop that she has come up with, which is the Melt and Pour Soaps workshop. So she is a natural beauty and wellness coach. She's very passionate about living a holistic life, living a life that is environment friendly. And she's also an entrepreneur. She's the co-founder of a really, really beautiful brand, Nature. You should definitely check out her line of products if you are interested in what she has to share. All right, so I'm going to stop sharing the screen now, and I would invite Sunmeet here for, taking over the session, taking forward the session from here on. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Ishita. A very warm welcome to all of you. Thank you for taking out the time for joining this session. I'll just start sharing my screen. Sorry. Just a sec. I hope it's visible.
Yeah, it's visible, Simi.
So I'll just start with a small introduction about myself. In terms of family, I live with my husband. My son is 10 years old. I have a dog. My husband's from the armed forces background. We both have done our postgraduate diplomas from IIM Ahmedabad. In terms of hobby, I like numerology, I like music, I like traveling, I like cooking. I'm a Dutch national, as Ishita has already said so. I, in fact, have a dual nationality. And in terms of profession, I've been a hotelier, I've been a travel person. I have 15 years of experience in the corporate world. And last 3 years, I'm into my own venture. And me and my husband, we have started this company called Nature. And I also wanted to share all the knowledge I was gaining. So I started doing these workshops along with WellCure, and I do a series of workshops along with them, skincare, hair care, home care, lots of them you can check out on WellCure page. And this is on DIY soaps, this workshop. And this is the basic mantra which I follow for all my workshops for natural living. What you cannot eat, you should not be applying it to your body. Ideally, everything that you consume or that you apply to the body has to be, should be ideally plant-based. So this is the structure of the session today, what we'll be discussing before we move on to the live demo. You can keep putting your questions in the chat window and we'll take them up after this is done, the theory part as well as the live demo. So why do we need to make soaps? Why do we need to go natural? Soaps are available aplenty in the market and they're cheap and they give you good lather, they smell well. So why should we even making the effort of making soaps? Because a lot of products available which are present in the current day commercial soaps. Many of those toxins are mentioned here on the slide. And like soaps, for example, they have out of these, they have sodium lauryl sulfate, they have triclosan, they have perfume. And all these chemicals, they cause, they are carcinogenic, they cause cancer, birth defects in kids, reproductive problems in women, learning disability in children, infertility in women, and skin allergies. So we often think that it's, you know, when there's an issue like that, that it could be our diet, it could be something wrong we are doing in our diet, in our lifestyle. So what we fail to look at are the products which we are using on the body, products we are using at home. So all of them need to be allergen proof as well. And we don't think about those. So we'll learn in this workshop the differences between the commercial soaps and the natural soaps and why we need to get into natural soaps. So these are the top six ingredients, which if you see on the label of your soaps, you need to avoid and you should ideally not be buying them. So fragrances, parabens, SLES, SLS, I cannot pronounce the fifth one, but you can definitely read it on some of the soaps. And then coca, mido, propyl, betaine, and triclosan. So all of these ingredients are usually prevalent in the commercial soaps. And those soaps are actually not soaps. They're the actual word for them, like Dove and Lux, they're all syndets. Syndets is a short form for synthetic detergent. And that is what most of the soaps are, which is just a concoction of chemicals. They are not made in the traditional process. The base is not oil. That is what a natural soap is made of. So you need to be wary of these products and you need to avoid buying them. So soaps are not the only way how chemicals enter our bodies. Chemicals enter our bodies through various ways. It could be the pesticides in our food. It could be through the pollution in the air we breathe, then plastics, metals, the flame retardant chemicals in like furniture and in the paints which we use at home, personal care products, pesticide in our food if you're not buying organic stuff. So there are many ways where chemicals enter our bodies. And as we speak, we all have between 400 to 700 chemicals prevalent in our bodies, which have started, you know, from the time we were kids till now. And there are many things you can do to detox your bodies, which is not in the scope of this course, but that is something we should all consider if we want to have a disease-free existence. So what happens when you have a lot of these toxins? What are the symptoms? So all of these are the symptoms, you know, stubborn weight, which would not go off, constipation, body odor, constant exhaustion, chronic fatigue, insomnia, brain fog. So all of these are symptoms that we have chemicals in our bodies. These are some of the soaps which I have used in my school and college days. And that time I used to buy soaps just with the smell. I would just go and I would see the brand. Okay, I identify it with the advertisement I have seen. And then I would smell it. Okay, smells nice, you buy it. But that is not how we should be buying soaps. We should ideally be looking at the ingredients. And if the ingredients sound like chemicals, if there's something which you do not understand, research on them. And if you think that they are carcinogenic, that is what comes out of the research, then don't buy it. You will have to probably do that research maybe 10, 12 times. After that, you'll start getting a hang of it and these words will probably make sense to you because you would have read them somewhere or the other. So these soaps I cannot buy. One is Lux, one is Dove, one is this one is Mysore Sandalwood. So all of them have the chemicals which we spoke about. So what is natural soap made of? How is natural soap different from the commercial synthetics? It is made with oil and lye. You mix oil and lye and then this chemical reaction called saponification takes place. And post that, what remains, what comes out of it is soap and glycerin. You also add essential oils and natural coloring to the soap for the fragrance as well as the color, and then you get soap and glycerin. That is the resultant product. So soap is neither alkaline nor acid. Here oil is acid, lye is alkaline. You mix both of them, it makes a neutral soap along with glycerin. So that is the basic chemistry behind it, and that is how naturally soaps are made, and these are safe for our skin. And these are all the ingredients that are required for making soap. So there are only four ingredients mentioned there. Whenever you see 20, 30 ingredients, 40 ingredients mentioned on your soaps, on your shampoos, on your body washes, face washes, please be wary of it and do some research before you buy them. So soaps, like I said, this is the reaction that happens on the bottom of the slide. So some oil, lye, and you mix them, you do the saponification process, and you get soap and glycerin. So that is what the thing is. And some people are concerned about lye, but after the saponification is complete, there is no oil and there is no lye. It is a neutral substance which comes out of this reaction, which is soap. Just like when you see water, what is water? It is H2O. What is it made of? It is made of hydrogen and oxygen. So it is made of two gases. But when it comes together, it becomes a liquid. So this is neither hydrogen nor oxygen. It's a new substance that is made by the chemical reaction. Something like that happens with soap also. Oil plus lye makes soap, and the soap is absolutely safe for the skin. There's no lye that remains in it, and it doesn't harm the skin, and it's not also possible to make soap without lye. So lye is a necessary ingredient, but there is no lye that remains in the end product. So there's nothing to be worried about. So soap can be made by these two processes, hot process and cold process. In hot process, you heat the oil and lye and you cook it for a couple of hours on a crock pot. And after a couple of hours, the saponification happens with the heat and you get soap, which you can use within 24 hours. However, in cold process, you just mix the oil and lye. There is no heat and you let it cure for 4 to 6 weeks. So these are the two processes which are used industrially for making soaps. There is this term Castile soap. Many people ask me what it is. So Castile soap is the original form of soap. Earlier people used to make soaps with olive oil, and the word Castile comes from there. And now, of course, we have soaps with all kinds of oils. They're made with coconut, castor, hemp. They're also made with butters. These oils give the soap the lathering quality, and they become very moisturizing, and you do not need to use any moisturizer after you've used these kind of soaps. So Castile soap is like the basic original form of soap, which was made with olive oil. I just thought I'll clarify. So what we are going to cover in this workshop in the next 2 days is soap making with melt and pour soap. So melt and pour soap base is also made with the same process. It can be hot or cold process. And so the entire saponification process has already happened in melt and pour soap bases. And the soap base, which you have, like I have one here. So this one, it does not require any further heat or any chemical reaction. The soap base is already ready. You just add whatever additives or colorants or essential oils you need to add, and you make different types of soaps. You can make soaps for men, for women, for kids, for babies. So with a few types of melt and pour soap bases, you can make soaps for the entire family. It's very easy, and they're completely safe. Just a sec.
Sunmeet, stop sharing and then share again, and then close on annotations.
Okay. I think it's okay now. So we're doing melt and pour because it is the safest variant in hot process as well as cold process, since there is lye there and the lye needs to be processed. It needs to be cured. And lye is in a very strong alkali. And if it accidentally comes on your skin, it can even, irritate or burn the skin depending on the quantity. So you have to have that complete gear when you're making soaps from scratch. Like you have to have full gloves and you have to be in that lab coat kind of, attire. You have to wear goggles on your eyes and also a face mask, the complete plastic or glass face mask. So no part of your skin can be left open, because when you're cooking the soap base, if even a speck of it comes off, it can technically burn your skin. So it only becomes safe when the saponification has taken place. So which is why for this workshop, we're choosing the melt and pour soap base, because the saponification has taken place. This is absolutely safe. Your kids can help you in making these soaps, and they can be a part of the process. The entire family can get together and, make different soaps. So it's the safest variant of soap making, which is why we are exploring it here. So in melt and pour soap bases, when you buy online, the links will be given for those who register for the workshop and those who get the ebook. So you get all kinds of variants in melt and pour soap bases. You can buy, you can experiment with different soap bases. See which one suits your skin better, or your family likes it better, and accordingly buy those. There are many essential oils. Essential oils are made they come from plants and flowers and different parts of plants by steam distillation process. And there are over 200 variants of essential oils. Many people ask me which are my favorites. So these are my personal favorites. These are what I use when I have to make soaps for myself or my family. Just like I said, with the soap bases, with the essential oils also, you can experiment with other essential oils as well. See what appeals to you the most, which fragrance you like the most, and then accordingly go with it. Whenever you're buying essential oils, you have to ensure that they are organic and therapeutic grade, and that is the basic necessity. Otherwise, you can buy any brand or any essential oil you want. In terms of colorants, there are all kinds of colorants available in the market. But to make a natural soap, you can go with natural colorants, though there are many chemical colorants also available in case you want very jazzy and loud colors like magentas and purples and deep blues. Those kind of colors are not there in natural colorants. The natural colorants are very pale, muted, sober, those kind of shades you'll get. But I prefer to use these natural colorants only. So if I have to make a yellow soap, I would put turmeric in it. If I have to make a pink soap, I would have Ratanjot infused oil in my soap or a rose clay in it. If I have to make a green soap, I'll put a green clay in it or spirulina powder, moringa powder, hemp leaf powder. So for every color, you will get, some natural herb or spice or some powder which you can add. And accordingly, you can choose the color. So this is the way to go as natural as possible. These are some of the ideas, for natural colorants and what kind of shade they would give, depending on the quantity you use. So even in like turmeric, if you use like a tiny pinch, it'll give you a lemon yellow color. If you use like, maybe 2 pinches, it'll give you a deep yellow color. If you use half a teaspoon, you'll get probably an orange color. So this is the quantity. You can also, vary the shade you get in your soaps. So we'll be experimenting with different colors, and I'm going to be using only natural colorants, and we're going to be experimenting with designs as well, using these natural colorants to make attractive soaps. So a lot of designs are possible in Melton Pore. What you see on the left-hand side is layering. It's called layering. So, you put different colors of soap bases in a mold, one layer after the other. You let it dry, and then this is the kind of soap that you get. What you see on top is called swirling. You put a darker color, and then you put a lighter color on top, and then you swirl it with, a back of a spoon or something. So you get a design like this. What you see on the bottom is embeds. So we're going to make, these tomorrow and day after. What you see at the bottom is embeds. So you cut one color soap pieces in small pieces. You take another color soap base, you pour over it. So this is embeds. The another way of coloring, a simpler way, is to buy a very beautiful mold and just put, a solid color into it. The one you see on the right hand side. It's a beautiful floral mold, and you don't have to do anything. You don't have to make any design. The mold is so pretty, you get a pretty looking soap. So today we're going to have, this right side. So we'll choose a very pretty mold, and then we'll make our Rasool clay soap in that. So why Rasool clay and what it is? So Rasool clay is like it's a Moroccan clay. And like all clays, this is for detox and cleansing. So like it's summers and you need to really detox your skin and cleanse. We sweat a lot right now. So clay soaps are very good for summers. And Rasool clay is not only good for the skin, it's also very good for hair. Some people add Rasool clay to their liquid shampoos and they wash their hair with it. So This soap is extremely good for those who have who sweat a lot or who have very oily skin. So it's very good, you know, to detox your skin and really cleanse it thoroughly. In the next 2 days, tomorrow and day after, this is what we're going to do. This is the theory part. And then in the practical demo, these are the 10 recipes which we'll be covering between tomorrow and day after. And in the solid bars, we'll try to give design to our soaps, try to make attractive soaps, whatever is possible in Milton Hall. So Ishita, that is it from me. In terms of the theory part. Ishita, do we move to the demo?
Yeah, Sumit, so everyone, we will be moving on to the demo part of the session now, and then we will take up your questions. So Sumit, do you need 2 minutes?
Yeah, I'll take 2 minutes, yes.
Okay, all right. So I'll be projecting a video till then. We all take a 2 minute break. Or maybe for people who have joined in just now and who are asking questions related to the workshop, I will quickly take you through that. Okay, so for those of you who missed the beginning of it, what Sunmeet basically covered was some theory part of it. And even if you missed it, we will be providing the recording for today's session on the same WhatsApp group that you all are a part of. So please don't worry about that. Regarding the upcoming workshop, we are going to be covering the basics of melt and pour soap making. There will be 10 recipes which will be covered, and it will be a mix of solid bars, body washes, face washes. Sunmeet will also guide on which are the best fragrances that, you know, blend well. You can also learn how to personalize the soaps, which means how to beautify your soaps using different types of molds, natural colorants, you know, what kind of design techniques. Sunmeet just took us through a few design techniques, so she will be teaching some of them in the workshop as well. And basic soap wrapping and packaging method will also be covered. So in this workshop, we will be covering 2 live demos. There will be a recipe ebook, which you will be getting, online shopping links for all the ingredients where you can source it from. There will also be a 30 days email support. So you know, in case you have questions and doubts after the workshop, you can reach out to Sunmeet and get your doubts clarified. And you will also be given a special e-learning access with all the recordings and resources. And this access will be for 90 days. And what will be covered in the live session. So tomorrow and day after, we have the actual workshop where a couple of things in the theory part. There will be a practical 4 recipes in the practical part, which will be covered tomorrow. And on 17th, we will be having primarily a practical demo where, you know, a few more recipes will be covered. So it's a mix of all kinds of recipes. And of course, we will be surely taking up as many questions as possible. So you all can take a note of the recipes that will be covered
so we can start with this. So there are various kind of melt and pour soap bases like we discussed. So this is the this one is the shea butter melt and pour soap base. You can also get it without shea butter. And then I have some soap bases which we'll be using tomorrow. I'll just show them to you. This is activated charcoal soap base. It's black in color. You can also make activated charcoal soap by putting activated charcoal powder in this. So it can be either or. And then we have, this is honey soap base. This is for people who have dry skin. This is aloe vera soap base. And you can also get transparent soap bases and add all these ingredients to them. So we'll start with the Rasool clay recipe. So I'm just going to cut this. You need to have a nice, a very sharp knife for cutting the soap bases. So you can also put like a big chunk of soap base, you know, for melting. The melting can happen two ways. It can happen in a double boiler or it can happen in your microwave. It is easier in the microwave. And mostly microwaves are used, but you can also use a double boiler. Double boiler is, suppose you put the soap base here. And this you put in a jar with boiling water, and you keep it for a couple of minutes, and then the soap base melts. So that is the other way. So for those of you who do not use a microwave or do not have a microwave at home, you could consider doing this with the double boiler. So if you cut the soap base in small pieces, it melts easier. So I have cut the soap base in small pieces. Now I'm going to put this in the microwave for 30 seconds. Microwave is right here. So don't melt the soap base in one go for a longer time. Don't melt it. Don't keep it in the microwave for more than 30 seconds because it can burn also and you will not know since the quantity is less. So do it in 30 second spurts. Do it 30 seconds, take it out, just see whether it's melted or not. If there's some chunks remain, keep it back. So as you can see that some chunks remain over here. So I'm going to keep it back. It's not completely melted. So I'm going to put it inside for 30 seconds more. Till then, we will prepare the rasool clay. So there are some people who add the clay to the soap mix just like that. However, if you put it like powder in that warm soap base, then you will you might get specks of rasool clay in the soap. If you want it to be nicely dispersed, then it is a good idea to mix it with some glycerin, as it is soaps have glycerin, so it's nothing additional you are adding. So if you are adding any powder, so it is a good idea to mix it in glycerin and then add it to your soap base. You can also mix it with any oil of choice, but I prefer glycerin. Oil can make it too oily, especially for summers now. Just make it into a nice paste, and then you can add a teaspoon or two of this to your soap. So this is rasool clay, very, very nice for the skin. So just see, this is the consistency we require when we are adding powders to the soap. It should be like this. So this is now ready to be added to the soap base. And we are going with this. This is the one which I have chosen for today. It's an angel shaped mold. So we're going to use this. To prep up the mold, I'm going to spray some alcohol to it. This is rubbing alcohol. I'm just going to spray here. This is the soap base now. It's completely melted. This is what it is. So I'm going to add the rasool flake to it. And you can add any essential oil of choice. I'm going to be adding lavender to it, but you can add any essential oil that you like, the smell you like. If you want a citrus soap, because it's summer season, some people like citrus, you know, add orange or lemon or anything, peppermint and lime. You can even add a combination. I'm going to add a few drops of lavender essential oil to it. So now we pour it to the soap base. I'm going to, this one is half, so I'm going to add some more soap base so that I get two complete bars. It becomes very difficult to use half a bar. It keeps slipping from my hands. I'm going to now give this a 30-second stir in the microwave again. After you pour the soap base, if you see any bubbles on top, you can again spray it with alcohol. This is rubbing alcohol. The bubbles go away with that. So this soap will take at least half an hour to solidify. So till then, we can, you know, we can do our question and answers, and by then I'll be able to demold and show it to you. So now this is very light brown in color because I added the white soap base to it, and there was only a little of rasool flake lying here. So I can just pour it here so as to get some design in this second bar of soap. So this will become like a layered soap. So this is done. We now need to wait for it to harden. And Ishita, we can now take the questions.
Sure. So I will be opening the forum for questions, and you can post in all the unaddressed questions now in the chat. Yeah, please start putting your questions down. I will be taking them up one by one. So first question is, how can we make the soap base? So I think that needs to be purchased, right, Sunmeet?
Soap base needs to be purchased, and we have provided links in the ebook with all the registered participants get. So you know which one to purchase, and there are various variants you can choose whichever one you like.
Can these natural colorants be added to melt and pour soaps, or do we need any preservatives?
You don't need to add preservatives. The natural colorants can be added as long as they are dry. So like I used Rasool clay powder. So if you want to add neem, you know, you can't add a fresh neem leaf to it or neem juice to it. It will go bad. So to melt and pour soaps, you can use a dried version. So dried neem leaves, dried neem powder, that can be done.
Okay, so a couple of questions related to, you know, the recipe specific, how much, you know, in terms of grammage and ml. So in the chat, I have actually posted the recipe card of this particular, you know, soap. So please download it from the chat. We will also be putting it on WhatsApp. Okay, so we'll be putting it on WhatsApp. We'll be putting it on chat as well. Maybe what I can do is I can project the recipe card also right now so that everyone can have a look. Okay, so this is what will be shared in the WhatsApp group with you all, as well as you can download it from the chat. Okay. So Kushi says, can you give vendor details? So yeah, when you sign up for the workshop, you will get a recipe ebook where all the the shopping links will also be given to you, Kushi. Next is, will paprika cause irritation?
It can cause irritation. So paprika powder, though it gives a very nice bright orange color, but it is not recommended for people with sensitive skin or for kids or babies. For people with normal skin or oily skin can try using it. Okay. Otherwise, if you want to give an orange color, tomato powder is a safer option.
All right. What will be the shelf life of the soap?
So it depends on the base you buy. The bases are usually, the shelf life is a year. So, you know, whatever is the shelf life of the base is the shelf life of your soap. Nothing changes there.
What temperature did you melt the soap base at?
I did not take the temperature. I did it 30 seconds. More than 30 seconds, it has a tendency to burn. And 30 seconds is, you know, you bring it out, you check it out, you mix it, you put it back. So that ensures that the temperature doesn't become too high. And that is enough for the soap. But I did not physically take the temperature today.
Is melt and pour better or cold and hot process based soaps?
So even melt and pour is made from cold and hot process. That is the origin. But like I said, I mentioned about lye, it is unsafe to work with lye, which is why for us at home, for our DIY projects, this is the safest method. But everything comes from cold and hot process. That is the origin.
Essential oils are to be oil based or water based? Please advise.
Our essential oils are oil-based.
Okay. Which soap base is good?
We'll be giving links for the soap base which we recommend.
Yeah, and in terms of, you know, which you want to pick, I think it also, Sunmeet, you mentioned, depending on their, you know, preference, the skin type, for example, there is aloe base and charcoal, so...
Yes.
Yeah. Depending
my personal preference is shea butter, which is why I used it. But if your personal preference is honey or aloe vera or activated charcoal, for those with acne, activated charcoal is the best. So it all depends on your skin type and what you like. So if I bathe with a shea butter bar, I don't need any moisturizer after that, even in winters. So for me, this is my preferred base of choice. But we all need to experiment and see what suits your skin the best, and then you take a call. So buy smaller quantities earlier. initially, and then try all types of soap bases, see what appeals to you. Then you can keep buying, you know, just go with one type of soap base.
So how many drops of essential oil did you put in this?
So in a bar of soap, which is about 100 grams, you can put 8 to 10 drops of any essential oil of choice.
Okay, are the practical sessions covering cold and hot process soap? So we will be using melt and pour.
We'll be doing melt and pour, and we'll be doing different designing there and different colorants there.
What is to be done of the melted soap base if you don't want to make it?
So the melted soap can keep lying in the jar like this. You can cover it, you can keep it, or you can melt it again and put it back in a smaller jar, and then put a ढक्कन on top, a lid on top, and then just keep it till the next time. That's it. You can use it again. You can melt it again and you can use it again. Next time you have to make soap. And because it is soap, it comes off very easily when you wash it.
Okay. So I see a couple of questions with respect to what will be covered and which recipes we are going to be covering.
Should I share that slide which says what all will be covered tomorrow?
I'll share it from my end. So these are the recipes that will be covered in the practical. Session one is tomorrow, 16th, 4 to 6 p.m. We'll have the theory session in the beginning, followed by a practical. And then we also have on 17th an entirely practical demo. And in case you wish to book for the session, then you can use the scan code over here to make the booking. Right, so we have a limited period offer which is going on at 1099. In case you are interested, you can use the QR code and make the booking. So I will be moving forward with the questions, Sunmeet. Sorry, I just missed the track of, yeah. Okay, so vendor list for all those of you who have already registered with us, please expect it by tomorrow morning. We will be sharing all the details and you will be notified about it definitely before the session begins. So which alcohol have you used?
Rubbing alcohol, which you get from any pharmacy. Rubbing alcohol is what it's called.
Can we use it on the face and for kids?
The soap?
Yeah.
Yes, of course. It's for the face, it's for the entire body. And you can use this on the kids also, because lavender essential oil is safe for babies, for kids, for adults. Lavender can be used by everyone. Otherwise, some essential oils can be used for babies, can be used for kids, not for them. So many essential oils come with do's and don'ts, but lavender is the safest and you can use it on all, starting with babies. So of course, this can be used by all.
So there's a question for a soap which is best for dry and oily skin. I think you mentioned shea butter base, but
shea
is there...
Base is very good, yes.
So can we make multani mitti soap?
Yes. In place of rasool clay, you can also add multani mitti. That will give you a nice beige color. I think we are using multani mitti in one of the recipes in the next 2 days. So yeah, you can use multani mitti also. So you can give a layering to your soaps with that. So like in this soap only, I can have, a little bit of white base, then followed by multani mitti and soap, then rasool clay and soap. So it will give white, beige, dark brown color. So, that layering is possible if you have, if you use different clays and different colorants. So yes, it's very much possible.
So if somebody wants to sell it, will any kind of license be required?
Yes, there are licenses required, and my husband and his CA, they work full time on that. So you need to have a commercial space, you need to have licenses in place, and it's just not just one license, there are many. But I only look at the production part, my husband does the licenses part. But yes, we have a few licenses which you require for selling.
Can we make customized so some personalization techniques Sunmeet will be teaching us in the workshop. You can surely take it forward from there.
And I can also share, Ishita, I can share some videos, post the workshop, you can share with them. And there are many kinds of designs which are possible. So though we're only making 6-7 solid bars in the next 2 days, but there are more designs possible. So I'll share some videos and they can look at them and they can also, keep experimenting further.
Okay. Sure. You can share it with us and we'll share it on the WhatsApp groups. Can we also add milk to this?
Milk should ideally not be added to melt and pour soap bases. The soap will go bad. You can add only powders, and oils, nothing else, anything bright. So I don't think adding milk is a good idea. Milk has to be added to trace when you are making the soap from scratch, when you put in the oils and lye. That is when you can add all these juices and milk and other things, but not after the soap has saponified, not then.
So there's also a question on natural herbs. So I guess the dry herbs is something that we should be adding to the soaps, right?
You can add dried herbs also. I'll be giving some ideas tomorrow and day after on what all can be added. We'll be adding some herbs.
Okay. So one question is ki ye soap bhi market jaisa lather create karega?
So the lather will be lesser than synthetic detergents because of the SLS and other chemicals they add to it. They lather a lot. They even add SLS to our toothpaste. So because har jagah hame jhaag chahiye. So iski lather usse kam hogi, but this is absolutely safe. Agar koi bachcha nahate nahate isko muh mein dal leta hai, kha leta hai, kuch hoga nahi. I mean, soap doesn't taste good. It tastes like soap. But kuch damage nahi hoga. You will not have to rush to a doctor. This is safe. The other soaps which are just made with 10 chemicals added together, 20 chemicals added together, those are unsafe. You see warning signs on those labels. Isme kuch warning nahi hai. Ye safe hai.
Okay. Ritika asks how to prevent glycerin dew on soaps.
Oh, glycerin is an issue. It does happen, especially in summer. So, I have my AC on, so abhi glycerin nahi hoga. And when the soap, becomes cold and you demold it, the best thing is to just pack it. If you're not using it immediately, put it in a butter paper or something and pack it. So if there is no moisture from the air, then the glycerin will not form.
Okay, are we going to learn designer soap? So yeah, a few designing techniques will be covered in this workshop. Can we use soap flakes instead of bar?
Can we use soap cakes?
Flakes.
Soap flakes, yes, as long as they are, this soap is only, there are soap flakes of many, even for washing clothes and other things. So as long as it's meant for the body, yes, you can use it. Though I use bars, but yes, you can use flakes also.
So a couple of questions regarding the reason for putting rubbing alcohol. So that was to prevent bubbles, right?
To prevent bubbles. So when you're pouring, so because it is soap, it makes, those soapy bubbles. So if you don't want bubbles in the final product, you put the rubbing alcohol.
What is the maximum quantity of fragrance oil that we can add?
8 to 10 drops per bar of soap, per 100 gram bar of soap.
How long will this soap last?
It depends on your usage. So like in summers, if you're bathing more, longer, or you're bathing twice or thrice a day, it will last for maybe 15-20 days. Otherwise, it should last a month if you're just bathing once every day. So it all depends on your usage, whether you yourself are using it or your family is also using it.
Okay. So the fees is 1099. You can use the scan code. You can use Google Pay, Paytm. We will also share the links in the chat. Maybe Karishma, you can put it on the chat or even on WhatsApp groups. We will be putting the links. So for measurements, like we've mentioned, we've already put the recipe card in the chat. We'll also be putting it on WhatsApp. Does this soap dissolve quickly than commercial soaps?
Does this soap? Sorry, I didn't get your question.
Yeah, so will it dissolve quickly as compared to a commercial soap?
No, it should not. It will not dissolve very quickly. It will last, like I said, it depends on the usage, but it is a hard bar of soap and it will not dissolve very quickly.
Couple of questions on where can we get the Rasool clay. So is it available online easily?
I think the link has been provided in the ebook. Otherwise, I'm happy to provide. It's available online. I'm happy to share the link from where I buy from.
Is bentonite clay the same as Rasool clay?
No, they are different.
Should we keep it in the refrigerator for hardening?
No, not required. It takes half an hour to harden. Not required to keep in the refrigerator. I mean, you can keep it, but not required.
Is there anything that can be used instead of alcohol for the spray?
No, it's only alcohol.
The shelf life of these soaps, I think we've mentioned 6 months is the shelf life. So I think Sunmeet has already clarified that these type of soaps, they won't melt faster than the commercial ones. So there's one question which says, which melt and pour base is the best or the safest?
I've shared links of the melt and pour bases, which I have used and I like the quality. I haven't used all that are present in the market. But the ones which I have used and I like them, I've shared soap bases. So you can start with them.
Will you teach hand wash also?
Hand washes. Only the body soaps are covered in this workshop. The shampoos and hand washes are not covered. Hand washes actually would come in this thing, in home care. But I'm happy to give general guidelines on how to make a hand wash.
Is there anything that can be done with the remaining melted soap base?
You can just keep it, in a smaller jar, and you can use it next time. You can again melt it, add something else to it, or add to your more soap base and use it.
Can we use dried rose petals in the soaps?
Yes, you can. Yes. And in fact, I have dried rose petals. We'll be making a rose soap tomorrow. So I think we can use it in that. It looks very pretty.
Yeah. Will we be getting recording of the workshop? So yeah, recording of the workshop will be available to the registered participants. So Sushma says, you have a beautiful skin. Since how long have you been using these soaps?
It's been 2 to 4 years.
Next question.
It is due to my parents. Nothing to do with my soaps.
Next question is, how much do I have to invest first for the first time for all the tools and materials?
Soap base, I mean, it depends on how many essential oils you buy or how many ingredients you buy. We'll be teaching you 10 types of soaps. You don't have to make all 10. And you can just start with, one or two soaps that appeal to you. For that, it will hardly be, you know, like 600-700 rupees, because you have to buy like, you know, at least 1 kg of soap base. But that 1 kg will give you 10 soaps. So you can probably use it over 10 months. So, and if you just buy one essential oil, that will be 200-300 rupees. Natural colorants you get from your kitchen, like if you're making a yellow soap, like I said, turmeric. So something like that. So if you're using, you know, such kind of ingredients, it's hardly 500-600 bucks for, you know, making one type of soap. And if you're experimenting with more, then accordingly the money increases.
Okay. Which one is economical, lye or melt and pour?
There is no comparison. Lye is what is an ingredient to make all kinds of soaps, including melt and pour. So, but you're not dealing with lye here. I just told you in the theory part how soaps are made. We are buying melt and pour and we're making it because melt and pour soaps are safest.
Is there any chance of a change in consistency of the soap after adding essential oil or like cold process?
No.
Okay, can we add any oils to the soap without clays?
Any oils to the soap without clays?
Yeah, so I think if you are not using clays, is it okay to add just oils?
Yeah, you can just add an essential oil and you can make soap. So the easier soap would be like melt the soap base, add any essential oil to it, and then put it in the mold. That is the easiest one. This is just, you know, because Rasool clay is very detoxing. It is good for summers, which is why we're using it. It gives a nice deep brown color. So that is the only reason. If you want a deeper color, you add some more of Rasool clay to it. So that's the reason we're using it. Otherwise, you can make a plain soap with just essential oil.
If we add raw aloe vera gel, we have to add preservatives too?
Raw aloe vera gel is not recommended in melt and pour. You will have to use the store-bought one only. Otherwise, it will go bad. Raw aloe vera gel you can use if you're making soap based from scratch. Then you can use all these raw things like milk and juices and raw aloe vera gel. You can't use it in melt and pour.
So the next question is, will the workshop cover shampoo making also? So no, we will not be covering shampoos. We will only be covering soaps. We have a separate workshop, the hair care workshop, where we cover all of the shampoos and other things.
Ishita, whenever the questions are done, the soaps can be demolded.
So I'll take up the last two or three questions and then we can see the demolding of the soap.
Yeah.
Okay. Can we add dry flowers, leaves, and fruit peel powders instead of glycerin? Shall we add? Is it okay to use coconut oil?
Yeah, you can use coconut oil also. It's just that it mixes very well in glycerin, which is why I used it. But you can also mix the clays in any oil of choice and add it to this. Just be wary of the fact that with the excess oil in soap, the lather becomes less, which is why I avoided using oil. But those with dry skin, if you want to mix it with an oil, you can. But the lather becomes less. So you'll have to choose what you prefer.
Is there any particular recipe for different skin types?
I can give recommendations for different skin types, though we'll be covering 10 types of soaps, you know, and they're all for different types of people or different, you know, skin ailments. But I'm happy to give some more suggestions for some more issues or ailments you may have.
Okay. So just a clarification. So this is not a make-along class or workshop. We will encourage that you first, you know, just observe the demo carefully, ask all your questions and doubts. And then we do give you a support of 30 days over email where we give you time you know, to make the soaps at your own end, order for the ingredients, and then if you have any trouble anywhere, you can reach out to Sunmeet via the email support. So the 16th and 17th workshop is going to be the paid workshop. Today's was complimentary, but tomorrow and day after, you will have to register for the workshop. And yes, a few notes will be shared as well with you all once you register for the workshop. Please expect all of the resources that are a part of this workshop by tomorrow. So Sunmeet, we can maybe see the demolding of the soap now.
So we're going to demold this first because this one we had put in the mold first, so it is like colder. So this is the pure Rasool clay soap. It's visible?
Yeah, it is. It is.
It's a very beautiful angel. So I really like this particular soap mold. So we can further leave it to dry for some time till it's completely, cold and at room temperature. It is still a little warm from inside. This one you see is a layered soap because we put a whiter soap base later on, and this one was the darker one. So this is like a layered soap with design. So these are the two soaps which we made.
Wonderful. So maybe Sunmeet, you can also click pictures and share with us so that we can share the pictures with all the participants for better clarity.
Sure. I'll do that.
All right. So we are close to winding up the session for today. Just going to project the screen one more time in case anyone is interested. The sessions are tomorrow and day after, 16th, that's 4 to 6, and 17th, again 4 to 6. And we are going to have some theory part covered tomorrow. And in practical, we will be covering these recipes. And in the second session, which is primarily a practical demo, the soap bars will be covered along with one body wash recipe. And yes, so this is the scan code in case you are interested in booking for the workshop. So we will be giving you a 90 days recording access. So the workshop that will be conducted, recordings of that will be shared, and you will be given recording access for 90 days and an email support for 30 days with Sunmeet. So we'll take up a few couple of questions just for another 2 to 3 minutes. Is that okay, Sunmeet?
Sure.
Okay. So if there are any workshop related questions, if anyone has any doubts, please put that as well so that we can help you. So a few questions regarding drying the soap. Do we need to freeze it or just leave it there to dry? Sunmeet, are you able to hear me? Karishma, are you able to hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I think her internet got disconnected.
Okay. No problem. We'll give her 2 minutes to resolve that.
Sorry, the electricity went off for a minute.
Okay. So the question was that, so a couple of questions regarding drying the soap.
Did I miss any question, Shita? drying the soaps. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, drying the soaps.
You just soak them in the mold for half an hour and that's it. And then you demold them.
Okay, all right. So there is no requirement.
Once the soaps are completely, cold to touch and they are room temperature and they're not warm at all, we just wrap them in butter paper, which we'll do tomorrow. And that's it. Then you just keep them for later use.
So today's recording, yeah, we will be sharing today's recording with you all on the group. A couple of questions regarding costing of the soap.
Cost will be as per market. You have to check online what the competitors are selling, and accordingly, I mean, if you're talking about selling the soap, you'll have to see there. Otherwise, if you think what the cost of the soap will come out to be, the soap base and the essential oil and the colorant, I think 50 to 60 rupees. So slightly more than what you're getting, your Lux and your Dove and your Synthol, it will be slightly more because the essential oils are expensive. And it's safer. It's much, much safer than the ones which are available in the market, as we discussed.
How can the sweating of the soap be avoided?
So as soon as it cools down, just wrap it in a butter paper and keep it.
Okay. So, we'll take up one last question. So, Seem Mehta, how many grams? It's not very clear, the question, if you can reframe that. Can we use the soap immediately or preserve it?
Yes. So like if I have a shower right now, I can use the soap immediately. Yes.
And is it okay to use even after 1 year?
You'll have to see if the smell is still there because essential oils are there. So they are all natural. So, the smell may fade with time. And you'll have to check that and you'll have to maybe use it on the hand and see if it's fine. If the lather is fine and technically you can use, only issue is the essential oil smell may lessen. And then you can always melt the soap again, add some essential oil and put it in the mold again. So then you can reuse it.
Okay. So yeah, I think 50 to 60 rupees for one soap bar, that's about 100 grams. So I think that was what was said. So I think we're good to conclude the session for today and we hope to see most of you in the workshop as well. We hope that we have clarified most of the questions regarding tomorrow's workshop and we are really eager to see a lot of you participate with the same enthusiasm in our workshop as well. We look forward to having you and we will be sharing this recording. So don't worry if you've missed this. You will get it on your WhatsApp groups. You will also get the recipe which was covered today. If there is anything further, you can let us know. You can get in touch with us either through WhatsApp or our support emails, info@wellcure.com. So with that, thanks everyone. Whoever has registered, we thank you. And you will be receiving all the materials with respect to the resources, the recipe ebook, and everything by tomorrow. For those of you who have not yet, we would be happy to see you as well. So thank you, Sunmeet. We look forward to having the workshop tomorrow. And thanks, everyone. Have a good evening. Bye.